Creole. He came in with Cajun. He and Cajun both were turned into Indianapolis Animal Control. I already knew about both of these dogs. Let's see if we can get him to look at us and not out the door. Hey, buddy, it's okay. He's been a little nervous since he came in. They said at Animal Control he was a bit wary of his cage. I know Cajun seems a little more settled than he is, and he was a little nervous with hands coming in above his head. So Creole may have not been treated real well at some point, but he's warming up to us fast. I mean, when I say he's shy, he hasn't done anything defensive, anything aggressive. He's just real quiet and making sure everything's okay. We do have some staining on his back end. They haven't been here very long, and he definitely needs a bath. We don't know what conditions he was kept in before, but Jack, you said that Jack is here at the kennel. You said he keeps his kennel nice and clean?
He keeps his kennel good and clean anyway, so we let him out.
Okay, and that's a good sign, because I might have been concerned with some of that staining, which will wash out, though we might have had some problems there, but it sounds like he's just been in a situation where he wasn't really able to keep himself as clean as he'd like. And again, we'll get a bath for him. We just like to let him settle in a little bit before we put them through anything that intense.
And he gets more vetting to go to.
And he has more vetting. Plus, I mean, this dog, I'll go to the history in a minute. You know, he had an owner. He was tied to a tennis court and dumped. Another guy took him in for 3 to 4 weeks and kept him there. Then he went to animal control. Then he was brought here. So I think anybody would be a little confused at that point. They said they guessed his age at about 3 years, said he weighs 46 pounds. They called him stoic, serious, and watchful, which I think, you know, in that environment, all those other dogs and everything, plus they would have had him separate from Cajun. I think he was just nervous. The guy said he and Cajun came in together to the shelter, and again, like I said, they were found together by just a local guy in an apartment complex that found him tied to the tennis court fence. He said the owner said they were good with adults, hadn't been around kids. We may bring Brandon out in a minute here just to see, but we kind of wanted to settle in for a minute. Said very friendly with strangers. He said both of the dogs enjoyed walks, running, and tug of war. They were, when they were at this guy's house, and I was working with this guy, by the way, to get these dogs into our program, but I wasn't getting like regular response. It sounds like he traveled a lot. And then at the very last minute, he said, you know, you need to take them today or they've got to go to the shelter. And I was on vacation. I wasn't even in town. So I just said, okay, do it. I'll get in touch with animal control. And that's what I did. So Juliet Animal Control let us know when they were in and were ready to go. They had to, you know, go through this stray hole and so forth. The guy that kept him for 3 to 4 weeks had a female husky. He and Cajun both got along well with her. They did also have two male cats. Said they love to play, maybe not so much with small dogs. I don't know where they're getting that. They said that Buddy, well, they called this one Buddy. They called Creole Buddy. Said he liked to try to play with the cats, but they didn't want to play. So there's a possibility he's safe with cats. The guy didn't allow a lot of contact because one of them caught a bird, so they were a little concerned about the cats. He said they both lived indoors, played in the yard about 15 hours a week. He said they slept in a gated area in the living room. He claimed they were housebroken and crate trained. Said when they were home, the dogs just hung out with them in the family living area. When they left, they did put them in a crate. They had seen no destructiveness out of them. They did have a 6-foot fence, and he said one of the two of them had made some attempt to dig, but nothing significant. They didn't dig out or anything, but you know, we asked for detailed information on that, so that's the information he volunteered. He said they know no sit outside and cage. We'll try sit in a minute here. On the leash, he said they were good. They pull to begin with, but then they calmed down and said they were real good in the car. And he noticed, oh, there we go. Now look how much he's warmed up. So we're just taking it real slow with Creole. He seems like the more serious of the two, a little more nervous. But that's a big change right there. Absolutely. So that's good. Hey, buddy. What do you think? Can I get a close-up of you? Do you have any treats for me? Thank you, dear. Oh, can you just give me a little more than that? Thank you. Hey, Creole, want a treat? Well, hi. Well, hi there. He's like, hi, take me home. Here, you don't want it from my hand? Maybe you'll take him on the floor. You don't know me. He doesn't know anybody here, really, except Jack's the only one he's ever met, so. He wants to get out and run, it looks like. He's like, there's a big bunch of green out there. You wanna come on in? Just go slow and go under, like we said. There we go. Just see how he does with kids. Oh, there we go. He looks like he wants to give you a kiss almost, doesn't he? Yeah, good boy. So he has settled down quite a bit just since he came in here. Oh, he was wanting to give Brandon a kiss big time. There we go. Good boy.
Yeah, it looks like he just likes a couple minutes to size you up a little bit. He, like they say, the story kind of attentive.
Right.
He's like, okay, what's your story? As soon as I figure you out, then we'll see.
He is a gorgeous boy. We just need to give him a good bath and get him cleaned up. And again, we'll do that. We just try and, especially if they're, you know, a little scared from being bounced around a lot, we like to give him a little bit of time.
I'm going
to
start from fly strike by his ears. So he has been outside of a lot at some point, but it's all healed. It's like just scarred. It's not like open sores or anything.
Okay. All right, buddy. Hey. Hey. Aww. He said, I want to have a friend. There we go. Do you kind of like Brad a little bit?
Yeah.
So that's a guy scratching my neck. So he's going to make a great dog for somebody. Somebody that just gives him a little, you know, just a little bit of time to feel comfortable. And again, we have seen nothing defensive, aggressive, no behaviors at all, except just a little shyness out of him.
Right.
Oh, he sees kitties there. But you're the one they said you weren't scared of. You weren't mean to kitties. So we'll see. We'll check that out, too, after a little time.
Where are you going, silly?
So I want to find a way out and play in that field out there.
Yeah, so I was outside.
Okay, here we go. Yes, yes.
Jack took me for a walk.
Come here, Bill.
I came out here, and I like it.
Yeah.
He prances.
Yeah, he prances.
Is he prancing?
I saw him when you were walking over here. He was just...
There he's all full of himself. That's not a shy boy. Yes, he did. He did potty as soon as we got him out here. Good observation. Hey, buddy. Okay. Hey, buddy. Hi, Creole. Hi. Hi. Hi, buddy. Oh, he'd love to get out and run.
Oh, would he?
Somebody with a yard, take me home. There I go. I want to run. You can come on in if you want, Brandon. Looks like he's kind of watching you a little bit.
I just want to play with
Oh, well, that's a good boy.